Aetherflux, a Silicon Valley startup founded by Baiju Bhatt, former chief creative officer of Robin Hood, plans to collect solar energy in space and beam it down to Earth. With an estimated personal wealth of $2.6 billion, Bhatt is leveraging his resources to tackle the technical challenges of beaming solar energy from orbit. The company, employing around 20 experts from NASA JPL, SpaceX, Lockheed Martin, Anduril, and the US Navy, aims to revolutionize energy distribution. In a blog post, Bhatt says he's been passionate about space since childhood. His father worked as a scientist at NASA's Langley Research Center. In 2008, he co-founded Robinhood, helping millions of people access capital markets for the first time. His next chapter will be as the founder and CEO of a space startup that provides space-based solar power to Earth, using a constellation of solar power collection satellites. He says in his blog post that space solar power can revolutionize energy distribution, especially for areas where it's difficult or dangerous to deliver power currently. Places like forward operating bases are disaster-stricken areas where the power has been knocked out. Long term, he wants to deliver renewable and affordable energy day and night to power commercial and civilian use cases. The sun emits more energy in an hour than the Earth uses annually. That energy is abundant in space. It's just a matter of developing the technology to harness it for use on Earth. Unlike competitors like Space Solar, which builds massive kilometer-scale satellites in geostationary orbit to beam hundreds of megawatts via microwaves, Aetherflux plans to deploy a constellation of smaller satellites in low Earth orbit. These satellites deliver modest power initially using infrared lasers for higher efficiency and smaller ground receivers. This approach is less costly, targeting remote or challenging locations such as military bases, disaster zones, and industrial sites like mining operations. With advancements in space technology, companies can fly more often and for lower cost than in the past. Laser optics are cheaper and more efficient, and constellation management is better understood. Combining the improvement in technology with the rapidly increasing demand for energy, from electric vehicles to data and AI training centers, massive amounts of new power generation are needed. Now is the time, Bhatt says, that collecting and beaming down power from space makes sense. Aetherflux plans to launch a 100 satellite constellation to provide seamless energy delivery. Aetherflux's technology addresses critical needs for the US military, which spent $16 billion on energy in 2023. Beaming power directly to forward operating bases could reduce reliance on vulnerable fuel convoys, which claimed over 3,000 lives in Iraq and Afghanistan between 2003 and 2007. In disaster-stricken areas, Aetherflux's mobile receivers can restore power to hospitals and communication networks. Aetherflux isn't disclosing a timetable for their satellite constellation yet. At the moment, the focus is on their first demo mission in orbit to showcase a technical solution before scaling out. If you can cross that hurdle first, then it's going to put us in a position where we can zero in on the technologies that will let us scale, Bhatt said. Aetherflux raised $50 million in a new funding round led by Breakthrough Energy Ventures and Andreessen Horowitz, adding to $10 million previously secured. This capital will fund the launch of their first satellite to test power beaming technology from low Earth orbit. In addition to private investment, Aetherflux received its first government grant from the US Department of Defense's Operational Energy Capability Improvement Fund. This funding supports a proof-of-concept demonstration to transmit power from low Earth orbit, addressing urgent military energy needs. Aetherflux's technology could deliver power directly to forward operating bases, reducing the need for fuel resupply convoys and providing a strategic advantage. The company's compact 5 to 10 meter receivers enable flexible energy delivery, not only for the US Army, but also for the US Navy, allowing ships to receive power directly from orbit. This contrasts with the larger kilometer scale rectennas required by competing systems. Aetherflux's modular, laser-based approach positions it to compete by offering scalable, efficient energy solutions for military and civilian applications. The ecosystem, competitors, partners, and funding. Aetherflux finds itself in a space sector where it's competing with a number of other startups and government initiatives. Unlike some competitors, Aetherflux focuses on beaming solar energy from low Earth orbit to small receivers on Earth, enabling it to address smaller markets and even moving targets such as US Navy ships and perhaps commercial ships in the future. Some of its competitors are Starcatcher from the US, collects solar energy in orbit to power other satellites in orbit. Volta Space, US, orbits the moon to beam energy to lunar rovers and equipment. Space Solar, UK, builds large solar satellites in low Earth orbit, transmitting power via microwaves to kilometer-scale ground antennas. Virtus Solis, US, develops massive geostationary arrays for high-capacity microwave energy transmission. And Reflect Orbital, US, uses orbital mirrors to extend terrestrial solar farm operation by reflecting sunlight at night. China and European governments, including the European Space Agency's Solaris initiative, are also advancing space-based solar power, with China targeting operational systems by 2030. Upcoming events. Aetherflux has received its first satellite bus for Mission 1. Over the coming months, the team will integrate equipment onto the bus and verify all systems for a summer 2026 launch. The satellite, operating at a 550 km altitude in low Earth orbit, will transmit power using a 1 kW infrared laser for 30 seconds to 1 minute per pass to ground-based receivers. Exciting times in space-based solar power. What do you think of Aetherflux's mission to beam down power to base stations? Leave your thoughts or opinions in the comments section below. Thanks for watching. If you enjoyed this space video, consider buying me a coffee to help fund more episodes like this. The link is in the description. Space News Live is on Saturday evening or Sunday morning, depending where you watch from. The live stream is a great way for you to share your thoughts and opinions on the videos I posted this week, or on any space topic in general. I highlight the most thought-provoking comments on videos I've received, along with late-breaking space news and previews of upcoming content. If you've got the time, please tune in and say hi. Be sure to like and subscribe so you'll see our upcoming videos. We make videos every week covering the space industry, with an emphasis on the smaller space startups that aren't covered so well on other channels. See you soon.